the shape is the same as the other one.
I think we should do some digital pictures and let George see them.
And then just decide
whether we feel we want to slim that down or not. I know he was very keen
to keep a lot
of things exactly the same. Yeah. So.
Well, with Jango Fett, George wanted a definite link between the Jango Fett armour and the Boba Fett armour. Originally, the idea was that there would be an assumption that Boba Fett, when he grows up and becomes a bounty hunter, is actually wearing his father's armour. Originally, the Jango Fett costume was going to be white as a link through to the clone troopers. In a way, we made the link more to Boba Fett, with the colour of the using a blue leather for the armour and keeping it blues and greys, because that's more the colours that Boba Fett wears later on. With Jango Fett's helmet shape, we had to ensure that when he was fighting that we couldn't see up inside of the helmet, and it to be comfortable but safe, so if he's fighting there's nothing hard that's going to sort of hit on his neck. Those were quite difficult things just to work through, and that was a real combination between the people who were actually making the soft part of the costume and the costume props department, sort of working out fixings that would work inside the helmet and also things that would let the actor have sort of ease to take it on and put it off. Most costumes are not made to be saturated with water, so we just made lots of them. We made 3 for the actor and 4 for the stuntman. So we had enough that if they got wet, and he had a wetsuit on, or we had a wetsuit for him if he wanted to wear a wetsuit underneath so the water wouldn't soak through.